Hello friends, welcome to the course on Physics of Nanoscale Devices. I am Vishwendra Singh Poonia from the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, IIT Roorkee. And this course is part of the program NPTEL MOOC program, which is supported by Ministry of Education, Government of India. So as all of us are aware that transistor is one of the most important inventions of 20th century. And in fact, it is one of the most fundamental driving force behind revolutions in electronics and computing industries. Okay, and it is also among the fastest developing technologies because of the insatiable demand of high speed and small size. Transistor size has been continuously reduced, it is getting continuously scaled, and nowadays the active area of transistor is only few nanometers in size as compared to few tens of micrometers when transistors were first integrated into an IC. So this change in size, because of this nanoscale size, the physics of transistor is changing fundamentally. Nowadays, the quantum mechanics is becoming more and more explicit in physics of transistors. And that is essentially the subject matter of this course. If we look at the most fundamental level, a transistor operation is about controlling electrons in a piece of semiconductor. And what do we do to control something? We try to understand that thing. So that's what we will begin this course with. We will try to understand the nature of electrons. And that's why we will start with the basics of quantum mechanics. As all of us know, that quantum mechanics describes the behavior of electrons and all elementary particles essentially. We will see how electrons behave in free space, and then we will see from after that, we will see that how electrons behave when they are confined. Then we will see how electrons behave in solids. And from there, we'll try to understand how electrons actually behave in semiconductors. So once this basic understanding is there, basic understanding of electrons' behavior in solids, in particularly in semiconductors, is there, then we will move on to understand the transistor physics. And we realize that this transistor physics can be broadly divided in two parts. One is the electron transport, second is electrostatics. So these two topics will be the significant chunk of this course. First, we will discuss the theory of electron transport, we will discuss ballistic transport, and then generalize the idea of ballistic transport to higher dimensions of transistors. Then we'll see how electrostatics change as the size is reduced of the transistor. After this core discussion of this course, we will briefly discuss the thermoelectric effects and thermoelectric devices. Then we will also discuss some of the modern day devices, for example, the devices based on quantum dots and few atom systems. We will also briefly study the basics of ab initio simulations, the first principle calculations that are quite useful when we deal with nanoscale or atomic dimension systems. That's pretty much the overview of this course. I would be happy to hear any feedback about the content of this course. I again welcome you to join the course. I look forward to interact with you very soon when the course officially begins. Yes, thank you.